Stand by.
Hang on. Oh. Oh, shit. Here we go.
Okay, boys and girls, what we've got here is a little odd duck. I've got the bolt out and took apart. You're going to have to forget that, but I bought this little gun mainly because I wanted a real long bolt action 22 rifle. I forget how many inches this is, but it's a Springfield. Springfield Model 84C, made by J. Stephen Arms Company. I can't read this, but it's Summers in Mass. Anyway, it'll shoot 22 long shorts and long rifles. Anyway, it's a good looking little gun. It's a real good looking gun. It's got that Bakelite trigger guard. Trigger guard is broken. Somebody has carved 3 notches in the friggin' stock, which I can fix if I take my time. A little wood filler and use a little varnish, and you sand at the varnish, and yeah, you can move the color and move the pigment of the wood. That's a trick I'll show you one day, but I can fix it, and you'll never know it was there. Trigger guard, I can't find one specifically listed for this gun, but I found a few that looks like it. But anyway, that's the least of my worries right now. This gun, the firing pin. I shot this firearm. I shot about 100 rounds through it. Worked good. Had a couple misfires. That was it. And then it got to where it would shoot 1 out of every 5. So I took the bolt apart. This ain't really a how-to video on how to take the bolt apart. But anyway, there's a pin that goes through that notch right yonder. There's a pin that goes through the bolt. Anyway, you drive the pin out and shake the guts out of the bolt. Your firing pin comes out through that little hole right there. Well, anyway, here's what I found for a firing pin. I think it's had one put in it and it's been made. See how it's bratted, mushroomed? Which, you know, it is what it is, but you also can see it's flatter than a flitter. Get it here. I think it's focusing pretty good. It's flat. Should have a little more point to it. It also needs to be a little longer. But anyway, I took my cheap Harbor Freight ones because I didn't feel like going and digging out the good ones. I bought these. I think I give $10 for them. And I mean, unless we're building atomic bombs here, I think it's close enough. But anyway, I'm going to pick up my firing pin. Actually, I'm going to make sure I'm zeroed, which I'm not. Zero. Oh, wait a minute. Zero. Okay. Pick up her firing pin. Anyway, let's see where we at. Right there. Yeah, bad number. You can't forget it. Actually, I've got it. It wasn't what I got a minute ago. I only got 665 a minute ago. This thing, believe it or not, is slightly freaking metallic. Hang on a minute. Let me set you down here. See what we can do. This thing is slightly freaking metallic. Or not metallic, magnetic. Let's see. See, I'm getting 664. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go out here. I've got some old broke drill bits and crap. And I'm going to dig me out a drill bit that will fit. I'm not worried about the size of this. The length I am, but, you know, we can go from there. I'm going to find me a drill bit that goes in the firing pin hole and slides good, which is without lack of right there, that hole. I'm gonna find me a drill bit that goes in that hole, which actually my super punch fits in that hole. But anyway, I'm gonna find me a drill bit that goes in that hole and use the back side of it. That's my plan anyway. So let's go see if we can find a drill bit. And far as the length of this thing, which that's still in the mic here, I'm probably going to make it about 685. I might go 690. It can always strike too hard, cause a hard case ejection, or maybe even pierce the head of a 22. I don't really care. I can always take it back apart and take a little off. But there's one thing about it. You can only make it too short once, so I'm going to make it too long because I don't know what length it really should be. But I'm looking at this firing pin, and I'm going, you know, the way it's bratted on the back side, which is the left side there, you can see it. It's mushroomed, you know. There's at least that mushroomed right there, you know. So, you know, I don't know exactly. I don't know, I guess I could take it clear up to, let's see, hell, I could take it clear up to 700, I think, shine the darn thing, you can see it. See, I'm not adding much to it. I could go clear to 700. I think I will. I think I'll go clear to 700. I'll shape the firing pin because I'll lose a little bit when I shape it. Of course, I guess I can cut it to length after the fact. But anyway, to make a long story short, it can, you know, if it's too long, I'm going to run into the problem of not being able to actually close the bolt. I'll run into the problem of piercing the head. Anyway, to make a long story short, I can take it apart and I can shear this side. It's mushroomed on this one. I can cut her down to size, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go too. I'd rather go too big than too short. Too long than too short. I can always work it down. A 22 is not a dangerous thing if you're expecting some blowback. I mean, it's no worse than shooting a 10-22 because it's blowback operated, basically. So it ain't no big deal. We're not too worried about it. I'm not going to shoot any like CCI velocitors or anything. I'll use just some cheap bulk to try it out. But anyway, it's getting, as you can tell, it's getting dark. And I need to get me something made and test fire it before dark. So I'll show you what I come up with. Okay, I go out and I dig, and I come back with a couple drill bits. But y'all remember, let me zero this thing. I picked this one up, and I think I said that it was 78, 79. 79. Well, 78, 79, whatever. Anyway, I went and got this drill bit. It's pretty well spot on. But I got this drill bit. And as you can tell, it comes in at 94. Well, it was the first one I tried. I just happened to pick it up. Let me set you down here. Well, anyway, I took it and I stuck it in. It's almost a perfect fit. There's no real slop. It's perfect. The little spring that went on this, right here, if it goes on this, I'm using it. Bingo. I'm making my firing pin out of this one. It'd be a little heftier, less material to mushroom. It's a bigger, be a bigger pin. So that's what we're going to make it out of. We're going to make it out of this drill bit. I'm going to go out here and lop this off and do a little fashioning with a file, and I'll be back with you. I ought to have a firing pin in this gun in just a matter of minutes. Well, anyway, I took a piece of drill bit, I cut it, I fashioned it up, and I made a firing pin. As you can tell, I shaped it, and I made a firing pin. I wound up making it 10 thousandths longer. I wound up making it the exact length to the face of the bolt here, to this face. The face closest to us, not the face back in where the shell is. And it's also spring loaded. It'll actually press back. You know, they're how they're spring loaded. So, I don't know. We're going to test fire this thing and see if it fires. It's too dark for y'all to see that, but you'll see me shoot it one day. Let's see if it works. I'll tell you if it works anyway here in a few minutes. So, let's go. Let's put 5 rounds in it and take it out and see what she does. Yes, it worked. It was a success. Well, kind of, sort of, not a success. It works. It's the right length, that and the other, the way it is. But it has nothing to keep it from coming out. You know, the firing pin will fall out because it doesn't have the head on the back of it, which is no big deal. I'll take care of that tomorrow. It's actually really easy to deal with. There's a spring in there, the head, and that's what keeps it from coming out. Anyway, I got to put a head on the back of it. Basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a MIG welder and just put a little zzz, zzz on it, and that's it. That way it can't fall out. And other than that, I got it fixed. So, the firing pin was down. I wound up making that firing pin about 5 thousandths longer than what the original one was. That I took out of it with this war. So 5 thousandths of an inch is enough to make your 22 not fire, that's for sure. So anyway, we'll finish rigging it up tomorrow. I may show you, I may not. So anyway, we fixed it with a drill bit. See y'all.